My name is Wojciech Frejch. I'm a Chief Technology Officer at Argos Translations, and we will talk. I will show you a little bit of technical aspects of terminology management, and I will focus mostly on the, I would say, most underestimated step for terminology management, which is terminology extraction and creating of terminology lists in translation process, but not only translation process. So if you attended our previous webinar, you probably heard a lot of answers to the question why you should have why you should manage your terminology. Terminology management is practically mandatory in controlled language environments where you when you got the terminology and dictionary lists sort of enforced on your technical writers. Terminology management is a very important, crucial element of rule-based MT engines, where the whole process of creating a machine translation engine practically starts with a lot of terminology work. And the other step of the translation localization process where terminology management comes in play is the are the automated QA checks that can happen at the end of the process. And if you can supply the QA checkers with the proper terminology list, you can get better quality at the end. Again, if you want to hear about the terminology management in general, Michał will share the information how to access our previous webinar. So let's focus on the technical aspects. We know why. Let's talk about how we can get there, how we can get our terminology created, terminology lists created, and how it works usually. Of course, there are some exceptions, but usually it starts with the list. Somebody creates a list of the terminology in source language. I won't be talking a lot about the translation of the terminology. I will focus mostly on how to get the list of the terms from the source language. To simplify the demonstrations, I will assume that we talk about English as the source. So usually the whole terminology management cycle starts with the creation of the list with the terms, or even just creating a single term. Somebody says, this is a term, and we want to use it across our documents, and this term means this is the definition of the term, and there is usually a lot of additional information about the term. So how this can be done? It can be done manually. Author can decide, okay, I want to add this term to the list. The author can add the term to the Excel file, can add to the website where you store your terms. It can be done during the authoring process or after the document is finished and approved. Somebody can just go and just read it and find some terms that are worth storing. That's the very basic process. This process can be automated or semi-automated, which means that there are tools, and I will present some of these tools today, that can scan your documents and just can come back with some terminology candidates, with some potential terms. They can be automated or semi-automated. They still need a human being to approve the term or to decide if the terminology candidate is a valid term. This can be, of course, part of the other processes. It can be part of the translation process. So you send your documents for translation, and translation agency like Argos will start with creating a terminology list, will extract the key terms for the documents, and then will make sure that these terms are properly translated and they are consistently translated in the documents. Terminology list can be also created during the authoring process in automated and semi-automated process, and this is the ideal scenario that I will describe briefly. There are some tools. Unfortunately, they are pretty expensive and they require some well-controlled environments to give good results. So once you get the list, you have to maintain the list. So first of all, you start translating the terms to make sure that the translations will be consistently used in translated versions of the documents. Or you may find out that some terms changed or their translations changed. So you may need to update the terms, but that's a separate cycle. And maybe we will just make another webinar about this. It's not yet decided. So okay, how to get the list of terms if you don't have anything at the moment? So this is usually the first step, and usually it's underestimated. People don't create this list because they don't have tools, because they don't have time to do that, because it's not a part of the process where you create the documents. So the ideal scenario I just briefly mentioned would be working in authoring environment that has some sort of integrated language checkers that are supplied with the approved glossary terminology lists. So in controlled language environment, they can automatically detect new terms. So example of such terminology management tool is AcroLinks. And the terminology management from AcroLinks, I will not show you a demo because that's a third party company. If you want to see that, we can just put you in touch with the sales team from AcroLinks. So what can be done there? The terminology can be automatically detected and it can be put on a list, and that new terminology can be pushed through approval cycle if necessary. So these things can be automated. Again, this works perfectly fine in environment when you got the authoring environment, when you got XML or DTA authoring environment, and where you got the content management system and the checker from AcroLinks connected to that content. That's pretty, I would say, complex setup. And even getting to the point where you got that setup might take time, and it requires some funds. So what you can do, you can start with some simpler tools, and you can start using these extracted terms not only on the authoring step, but when you send the documents for translations, because that's the good place to apply the terminology to get the consistent results from a translation. So how it works in a translation workflow? So what happens at the beginning is usually there is a source text freeze when you know that your documents will no longer be modified, so you can send them out for translation. And the terminology, the key terms are usually extracted as a list of term candidates. They are not, so because of the methods that we use for terminology extraction, the list usually needs some cleanup, and it depends on the extraction tool, on the tool that was used to create the list. I will show you these differences in a moment in the demos. And once we got this list of terms cleaned up and ready for translation, we do the translation. And usually the important step in the terminology management in translation workflow is the approval through in-country review or subject matter expert approval. So we know that the extracted key term is translated in appropriate way. So what can you do? What extracted terms will give you in translation workflow? So you can supply we can supply, or you can supply your translators with translation for terms right when the project starts. So this is usually a good way to avoid questions and queries about the terminology. If you got the terminology before you start the project, there is a very little chance that we will have questions about these terms during the project. Because terminology recognition is available in practically all translation tools. If you use Trados, if you use MemoQ, if you use any other tool, Word Server, you will have the terminology recognition module in that tool. So the translators will be automatically supplied with the terminology suggestions from that tool. And these suggestions will come from the list you created at the beginning of the project. And that's at the beginning of the process, and at the end of the process, the translation company can check the output, check the final documents, if translators used the terms from these lists. There are other tools. There's a group of tools that allows to run automated QA checks. Most of the modern translation tools have these QA checks embedded, like in Studio, SDL Studio, like in MemoQ. You got these checks. You can run the terminology checks on the content, so it's possible to check if translators use the proper translations. So back to the terminology extraction, I will show you some free tools, and I will show you some commercial tools today. And the free tools, these are, I'm not sure what's the proper pronunciation, I didn't ask the author for that. It's AntCons, it's a free tool, but it's free for non-commercial use only. I will get back to these legal details in a second. Well-known Okapi Rainbow, which is completely free as far as I remember. And four commercial tools. One will be SDL Multi-Term Extract, which is part of the SDL Studio Translation Package. The tool that I'm not sure if it's still available, it was created by SDL as well, it's Phrase Finder. And it's a tool which is interesting because it applies different methods to extract the terminology. It uses linguistic analysis. And this will be the only tool with linguistic analysis that I will show today. There are not many of them available on the market. And I will show MemoQ, because MemoQ got some terminology extraction module as well. And this tool, this translation tool, became very popular recently. So it's worth seeing what they can offer. And I will show also the terminology extraction tool from ProMT package. ProMT is rule-based machine translation engine. And because rule-based machine translation relies heavily on the dictionaries and glossaries, this is the most important element of the package, the tool that allows you to create a glossary list that will be then processed to create a rule-based MT engine. So, okay, let's move to the demos. I will start with AntCons, or whatever is the pronunciation. It was created by Dr. Lawrence Antony, who is a professor at the Faculty of Science and Engineering at Waseda University in Japan. You get the link to his website where he stores not only this tool but also other tools, because his research interests include corpus linguistics, natural language processing, and these tools are free for non-commercial use. If you want to use them in any commercial project, you simply have to contact him and discuss the details. These tools are great because they can show you a lot about other tools as well. You can play with these tools for free. You can just see how you can just look for the patterns in the corpus. You can just analyze the corpus, and you can just see how other tools work. And as far as I remember, the source code is also available on that website. So you can just see how other tools work in reality, and you can do it for free. So let me just... okay, I hope I will be able to move. Okay. A few housekeeping items. I used the European Parliament corpus with English and with English content. I just extracted. They made English-Polish corpus available some time ago. I just extracted the English part of that corpus, and I haven't used the full corpus because it's just too big to get any reasonable results. I just took a part of that. I pre-processed a lot of. I practically in all tools I pre-processed the content, so you don't have to wait with me for a few minutes. And we, if the corpus is big, it can be a few hours as well when it comes to the terminology extraction, because usually these tools work on statistical basis. And this tool, and concordance, is shows you great how it usually works, how you get the proper terminology extraction, how the statistical methods work. So what I got here, I got the corpus file, which is plain text file, and this is the thing that is important when you extract terminology. Usually, it's the best way is just to keep the input for terminology extraction tools as a plain text files. We don't need tags there, we don't need any formatting, and the tools work great if they are supplied only with the plain text. So what I did, I just selected a small piece of that corpus and I just supplied it to the tool. And what I did, what are we really looking for when we look for terms? We usually look for words, but words, it would be too simple. We look also for the combination of words. And UnConcordance got this feature which is called clusters n-grams. And just to provide you with the proper definition, the n-gram is a sequence of n items from a given sequence of text or speech. So the tool analyzes the content, and what I can do, I can just play a little bit. I can just say I want to look for all two-word blocks in this corpus. It will take it a few seconds because it was pre-processed, hopefully not too long. Okay. A few more seconds. I'm not able to catch the results in advance. So what it does now, it analyzes statistically the corpus and it looks for frequently occurring groups of two words. Of course, there are lots of strange n-grams here, like of the, in the. Because this is caused by the way the tool works. It simply goes through the text. It doesn't exclude function words from a text. The more sophisticated tools will do that. But you can see that frequency, the most frequency occurring group of two words is of the. There's no value in that term. But on the other hand, you got member states. And if you click on the term, it will just move you to the concordance tab here, and if we wait a few seconds, it will display. You can see all the sentences, all the units where the member states appeared, and it's sort of centered on this term. So if you just browse through this. Sentences, you can see that this looks like a valid term. So this is the process which is which is, you know, upgrading the term candidate into a real term. So this is the part that is really hard to achieve in an automatic way, where this is where the human intervention is required. You have to clean up the list. This list is, of course, it's not very clean at the beginning, and the tricky part is to have a tool that will give you the list with the highest percentage of real terms on the term candidate list. And you can clean up this list and you can just get some real terms that simply contain some information. So we got the European Union again. Let's have a look. Of course, we know this is a proper term, but let's have a look. Maybe there is a bigger term that contains the European Union. Okay. So what else is on the list? Get European Parliament. Get human rights. Okay. So of course we can say I want to see all n-grams from 2 to, let's say, 5 words, but it will simply take a lot of time to get all of them. Let's see if there are any 5 grams, any n-grams with 5 words. They may of course not be proper terms, but this tool is basically to, you know, to play with your corpus, with your source, and see what you got there. Okay, a few more seconds, and that's the only tool that I will ask you to wait, because the other ones I get pre-processed in advance, so I can show you the results. Of course, you can decide you want, there is a minimum frequency box where you can say I want to see only the n-grams that appear more than defined number of times. Okay, so let's leave that. Let's see if I will get any any results meanwhile. So we got the educational tool. Let's move to something that will be, let's say, more advanced. The Okapi Rainbow is a part of Okapi framework. This is a free and, what is important, open source set of software components that is used by many companies and provides a lot of tools that support localization and translation process. And one of the available tools is the terminology extraction tool. It works in a similar way. It runs the statistical analysis of the content, but it got some other features that will produce much better list. It still works. Still no results. So let's move to the Okapi framework. Okay, this is the main window of the rainbow. I got again plain text file with practically the same content, and I got term extraction, predefined step in the pipeline. I will just go through some options here. Sort the results by the number of occurrences. It will show the most occurring term candidates at the beginning of the file. It will output into the text file. These two, terminology annotations, text analysis, this is for more complex XML workflows. Tokens, grouping statistics. If you use this and the remove entries that seem to be substrings of longer entries, you will get rid of the entries that might be sub-entries of other entry. So if you got, let's say, I don't know, members of European Union, it will, if you enable these remove entries that seem to be substrings of longer entries, you will not see European Union on the list. You will only see the members of European Union as a term candidate. Okay, let's run this. Minimum number of words per term. So we are interested in terms that are from 1 to 3 words and occur at least 2 times in the content. So I will run it, but I got it already pre-processed. So I can show you the results. Just 1 second. Okay. And you can see that we don't have this in the and other function words. They were removed from the candidate list, because that's the thing that Okapi framework got, which is not available in other free tools. It can automatically exclude these function words because it got its list. There is a, you can supply it with your own list of stop words. The stop word is something that is between the terms, that is not a term, but it's a word that appears in a sentence between different terms. File with not start words. These are the words that cannot start the term, not end words, the words that cannot be at the end of the term. So the empty, it will use the default settings, which for English they are pretty okay. Let me just see the results. You can see that okay, we got the member states, which might be a really nice term, European Union, European Parliament, okay, citizens, market, treaty. Yep, and that's up to your linguists or your authors to decide which of these candidates can be promoted to a real term and then translated and then used in the translated document as a term. Oh, we got human rights and so on and so on. Okay, so that's the second tool, and this one is completely free, so you can use it for free. Few words of you will really need a fast machine to run that tool on a bigger corpus. I would say that as fast processor as fast as possible, SSD drive, and as much of the RAM memory as possible. So that's unfortunately the disadvantage of the statistical approach to terminology extraction. You need a fast machine, but they are not that expensive nowadays. So that's I would say that's the only disadvantage of that free tool. Okay, that was another free tool. We will move now to the area of commercial tools. And I will start with well-known SDL multi-term with its multi-term extract component. It can run automatic mono and bilingual terminology candidate extraction. Bilingual, it means that if you supply it with the bilingual file, for example, bilingual TMX with your translation memory, it can run the terminology extraction on source, and it can analyze the target and look for the possible translations for just extracted terms. Again, this is a statistical tool, and it's based on the term frequency. I will not show the bilingual terminology extraction today, maybe in the next webinar, we'll see. The other advantage of using SDL multi-term is that you can integrate it with the multi-term, with the terminology management component from SDL. So you don't have to run any imports, exports, because for these three tools, you probably notice that what we got as the output is usually a text file or a tab delimited text file. So you can just put it in the Excel file and then you can work in Excel and just do the filtering, you know, removing the non-valid terms in Excel file. This one interfaces directly with SDL multi-term. So at the end, you get either monolingual or bilingual multi-term terminology database that can be used by translators. And this tool introduces another feature that was not available in the free tool, is the support for excluded terms. So you this can be used in different ways. You can just say that I don't want these terms to appear on the term list because they are either too generic or I don't want them. Or you can use it in a little bit different way. You can just use your existing list of terms to filter the new terminology candidates against these existing terms. So you won't see the term that is already in your terminology database, you won't see it again on the as a terminology candidate, because the SDL multi-term extract can detect that and can automatically exclude it from the list. So let me see if I got the, I think I got the, I will have to, okay, you can see my remote desktop. Again, I got the very similar corpus, monolingual corpus processed already, and what you can see, I will just show you the details of the settings for this project. Just 1 second. So I got this text file, and as you can see, there is that exclusion settings. I used the default basic vocabulary for English, and it is automatically excluded. Just have a look if I can display that. Yeah, this is the terms. This is the list of terms that will be simply automatically excluded from the terminology candidates. So these are usual. This is usually basic vocabulary, and unless you want this basic vocabulary to appear on your terminology list, you use the this basic vocabulary as exclusion list. So the term extraction, we got very few settings, like the okay, from 1 to 10 words. You can just say I just want 40 or 50 extracted terms, the most frequently occurring 40 terms. And there is a setting which is silence noise ratio. It affects the terminology candidates list. If you go, if you just move to silence side, you will get less term candidates, and they will probably be better. If you just move to the noise, you will have much more term candidates, and probably you will have to do more filtering. And stop for list, again, this is the list of function words for English, so they will not be, they will be automatically excluded, they will not be, they will be treated as the words that appear between the terms. So on screen you get the results of the it's almost 1500s of terms from that corpus, and what you can do here, you can just go through them and you can just see if they are good terms. you got more details about the term in other sub-dialogues. You got the term properties. You can see that there is a World Trade Organization. And the nice feature from SDL Multi-Term Extract, it automatically extracts also the acronyms. And it also detects different forms. And if you just click Concordance, it will show you there are 33 sentences in the corpus that contain World Trade Organization inside. Or you can see that it also detected the acronym. So you have these different word forms here. So you can say, okay, that looks like a valid term. So you'll say it's okay, it's fine, it's validated. You can also, if you got different domains set up for your terminology in multi-term, you can use the same setup here in multi-term extract. Okay, we got United States, we got United Nations, United Kingdom. You can see the acronyms are detected, situated. It doesn't look like you don't want it like you probably don't want it like a term, so you can simply delete it from the list. So you can also okay. You can also generate the sentences that will be stored in your term properties, because what's displayed here is only a concordance dialog. So this is the on-the-fly search through the corpus. If you want to put this president in the office of the council term in your terminology database, you may want to add the context to that term. So what you can do, you can generate sentences, context sentences, let's say 5. You can just change this number, you can just say 10. And this will be saved into your terminology database with this term. So this SDL multi-term is also nice because it processes not only text files. I use the text file for to work it faster, but I will just create a new project and I will show you what are the available formats. You can see you can interface directly with the existing term base, so you don't have to do any imports, exports. You will just get the term base automatically created. I will not use any term base. So you can process HTML files, you can process XML files, you can also add some Word documents, Excel files, and TTX files. So anything that usually goes to that is used in translation process can be processed with that tool. Okay. So let's see what else is left for demo. So the next tool is SDL tool again, but it's Phrase Finder. It's a pretty old tool. I'm not sure if you can still buy it from SDL. I'm pretty sure that if you talk to SDL a little bit, you can get a quote on this tool. But this is pretty old tool. I think it's something like 7 or 8 years old. But it still does some things that other tools don't offer. It's SDL Phrase Finder runs linguistic analysis on some languages only: English, German, French, Spanish, and Italian, as far as I remember. But it works very good on English. What it does, it also analyzes the sentences, and it does part of speech tagging. So it comes back not only with the list of terminology candidates, but it also tells you if it's a verb, if it's a noun, or maybe it's a noun phrase. And noun phrase is something that we usually look for in terminology extraction, because noun phrase, or as some people call it, nominal phrase, is a phrase which has a noun and which performs the same grammatical function as phrase. So usually, typical noun phrase consists of a noun, which is the head of the phrase, together with zero or more modifiers of different type. So I will just, let's see what it means in reality. What I got here is again the same corpus, which was processed with SDL Phrase Finder. And okay, there are different modes, there are different results that I can get from SDL Phrase Finder. You have to excuse me, it will do some data filtering, and that's the limitation of that tool. It's not a very fast tool. So let me just show the results for the words, and then I will switch back to phrases. You have to excuse me, And the other limitation of the tool is that it can process a pretty limited set of input formats. Definitely plain text, HTML, some, as far as I remember, some XML, but I wouldn't expect any TTX files. It will work with the old SDL format, the ITD files. And you can see we got, by default, it capitalizes everything. All the words, they are capitalized. You can just, you know, you can just convert that into small letters in the export, or you can just switch it off in the settings. So you can see that this is the typical. We got the frequency. It is sorted by frequency. These are the most frequent occurring words. But let's have a look. We got the report. We got the report, and we got the original. It appeared as report, reports, reports, reported, reporting. And it detected that it can be noun or verb. It was found in lexical database, and it was detected it can be noun, it can be verb. So you can have noun report, and you can have verb report. And you get context sequences here as well. And that's the information that sometimes is very useful, and you get it from SDL Phrase Finder. So I will just switch to phrases, and it will get more interesting. Okay, so we got the member state, noun phrase, got the European Union, got the European Parliament, got the internal market, again, noun phrase. We got the market, but it's not only, the market might not be an interesting term, but the internal market, you can see that it appears several times. It's a noun phrase, it's a noun with the modifier. So it's the same with renewable energy. And you can see that actually this is, it shows the Portuguese presidency. I used exactly the same corpus here, and you can see that the phrase finder with its lexical analysis, when it displays really interesting phrases, you probably would have to spend more time on term candidates from other tools. But this tool gives really nice phrases as a term candidates, like consumer protection, death penalty, young people, energy policy. So these are usually the terms that we are looking for. Some of them will be, of course, generic, and you may not want to include them in your terminology database. But if you process the corpus that contains a lot of I would say market-specific or industry-specific terms, they will be detected, they will be shown here. So let me just show you the settings. Again, we got maximum number of words per term. I didn't set any, so we can have, you know, even 5 words in term. You can just display a few items from the top, and you can just show only some context sentences to make it work faster. And this is the part that is much more configurable here. So you can ignore the words from a block list. Non-maximal matches. It means that the words that were not found in lexical database that have some matches, but they are not found in lexical database exactly in the same form. You can just exclude the words that were not found in the database, the function words like the, in, and so on, and you can ignore the numbers. And ignore capitalization. You can just set how it should. Actually, it works now with all uppercase, so it just converts everything to all uppercase. But you can just modify that setting. So what you can do, you can have block list. You can have a list of words that you can automatically remove from the terminology candidate. And again, you can actually just use the existing terminology list. You can just put it here and not see the same term appearing as a term candidate again. And presentation, this is the way it is displayed on the screen. And what is important, because it automatically detects different forms of the same term, you don't have to scan the terminology candidate list for different forms of the same term. It will automatically do that for you, so you can see only the root form of the term. Okay. Unfortunately, the exports from PhraseFinder, they are limited. You have to play with tab delimited files, with Excel files a little bit. It's not well integrated with the translation tools. Okay, so translation tools. So I will move to something that is probably very interesting for some of you. There's a lot of talks about MemoQ. MemoQ, of course, got its own terminology extraction module. And let me show that for you. I think I switched MemoQ off, so let me just run it again. Okay, a few more seconds to display the UI. And again, I use the same corpus, the European Parliament corpus, and the English part of that corpus to be specific. And then just what I did, I just converted that into translation project. I got it here. And so it converted the text file into translatable file in MemoQ. Okay, I got a document, and okay, see, I get the English text, I get nothing in the target. So in operations menu, you got extract terms command, and I already run the terminology extraction session, so I will just continue that session. So it will not run the whole statistical extraction, because it is statistical extraction. And now it displays something that I already processed before. So this is fully integrated with the translation environment. So you can have any term-based suggestions already from your existing terminology. You can see the occurrences from the translation document. You can filter the results. This is a very nice tool for somebody who extracted the terms from the translation project and wants to create a list with the translations for these terms and use it in the translation project. So, okay, we got a candidate which is called European, but we got European Union as well. And there are a few nice features that are not that let you work efficiently with that list. You can, of course, accept it as a term. So it will be upgraded from candidate to term status. Let's say I want to drop the European, but no, I want to show something else first. You have a function which is called, you have a link which is called hide and hide shorter. So what you can, if you just click it, you can see that the European Union is still a candidate, but the European only is now hidden, because the European is a part of European Union, so you don't want to, you can just hide it. So I want to accept this as a term. So you can see this is accepted. Okay, also I can just drop it. So it is dropped. So let's see, we got European Parliament. So again, we can just hide and hide shorter, and we can just accept it as a term. We can have human rights. And again, if you want to see the where, what are the, it's a European Convention on Human Rights. So okay, let's see, maybe it detected. Yeah. Unfortunately, it was limited, as far as I remember, to 4 words in a term when doing the extraction, so it didn't find that European Convention on Human Rights, it didn't find it, but what you can do, you can simply edit it a little bit. And you can accept it as a term. So you can see the settings that you use for terminology extraction. I will just use that. I will just run it again here. There is no, I would say, golden rule for these settings. What you have to do, you simply have to play a little bit with these settings and see what results you get. See, I got maximum length words, it's 4 words, I can just say I want 5. The mean frequency is 3. So all the term candidates that appear more than 3 times in the corpus, they will be displayed. So for the single word terms, MemoQ got some different options, like the minimum length and the minimum frequency. So if you got the single word as a term, it has to appear at least 3 times, or any number of times that you put here, and it has to be at least 3 characters. So the expression delimiters, it's you got the punctuation marks. They will be they will simply mark that's where the expression cannot, the term candidate cannot include these characters. When analyzing the contents, it will simply break on these characters. Okay, and of course you can have the stop word list, and there is an existing stop word list from Kilgray. So again, blocks as first, blocks inside, blocks as last. You can't have a term that starts with therefore, that has therefore inside, or ends with therefore. Therefore, so that should let you create much cleaner outputs with the terminology candidates. Okay, we've got 4 minutes left, so I got only one more tool to show, but this will be pretty specific one. It's a PromT, it's a terminology extraction tool from the machine translation engine, and I already did similar thing, already pre-processed the content, and what you have here is our terminology candidates with some relative frequency, and I have no idea how to calculate that number. It's this is a really strange number, but it's usually, if it's higher, then it means that the word appears more often than other words, and what we got here is a concordance context pane where you can see the term in a specific sentences. So you can see we got similar terms that were detected by other tools. Member states, European Union, What else? Yeah, of course, we get some commissioner, European Parliament. But you can see there is still some noise, some words that probably won't end up in your terminology database. And okay, and that was. Let me just switch to the last slide. That was the last tool for terminology extraction. So we still got a few more minutes. If there are any questions, please ask them through the QA and panel. And I hope Michał can read them for me.
Right. We have two questions so far. One of them was, can you save the results of this to an XLS file? Don't recall which tool it was dealing with, but I'm assuming it was probably somewhere earlier in the presentation.
Okay, so most of these tools, they let you export into tab-delimited text file. So if you got the tab-delimited text export, you can simply import that into Excel file, and then you can just do the filtering, and then you can just put the translations in the next column and convert it into terminology database in your translation tool. So most of them, the text tab delimited export is available in all tools. The Excel, not directly.
Thanks, Wojtek. And then the other question was, what's the best tool for extracting terminology from different document types and sources?
I would say there's no easy answer to that, because you have to take into account different factors. The important factor is your existing workflows. If you, and of course the volumes, the workflows, and the tools you use. So I would start, if you don't have anything at the moment for the terminology, I would start with some of these free tools. I would just play a little bit with the content, and this is the important factor. How easy you can process your content with these tools. If you can simply convert everything into text files, and it will not be time consuming, and if you get the content in the text files, which just properly saved as UTF or even Western Windows code page text file, I would start with different tools. I would see what I can get there. If I'm not happy with the results, if I'm not happy with the terminology candidates, if it takes too much time to filter these lists, to clean the lists, I would look into more advanced and more expensive tools, because it's for smaller volumes, the free tools will be fine. For bigger volumes, when the list of the terminology candidates will be long and will require a lot of cleaning, you may need simply a tool that will give you better results from the beginning.
Thanks, Wojtek. If anyone would like to ask about anything else or clarify something, please still go ahead. In the meantime, I'd like to invite you to contact us for more one-on-one presentations or to receive extra information on Argos, our services, and how we can support your terminology management efforts. Also, I hope you'll join us for upcoming webinars, the ones that Wojtek briefly mentioned. You can find more information on them by subscribing to our newsletter at the address on the screen. As we're approaching the end of the webinar, let me remind everyone that we'll be making a recorded copy of this presentation available. I will be distributing that out in the next few days. Since there are no more questions, I want to thank you again for joining, and see you next time.